It has gone beyond just the historical studies of our evolution and other things. We have come up with that it's now trying to promise in the future how to make life easier, how to make life more economically profitable and so on. And that's how the science of biotechnology comes. So irrespective of any semantic, like my chairman of Rules and Business has said, GMO is an offshoot of biotechnology, so you cannot divide the two. And then the scheme of this motion stands strong. Second is that definition of GMO is simple. There are two things in life, natural and human. And human is as a result of our advancement in science and technology and socio-economic development of the entire human species. Therefore, we have a problem here. The problem is that even in corporate America, whereby agro and agribusinesses are telling us that this technology is safe, both in the farm and also in the consumption end, we definitely know that it is not true, because any business of America, when you go into the big departmental stores, grocery stores, you will see now a growing business of what they call organic food sector. Organic foods are valuable, they are more expensive, they are more popular than the ordinary American. Existing from genetically modified foods. We are not talking about items that are really supplements now. We are talking about, you will see a banana that looks like rubber. They put a lot of enzymes and other things to modify its growth, its taste, its color, and its preservation. So it is a very serious issue. Yesterday, I was opportune to watch the Minister of Agriculture and also to watch the DG, or is it the Executive Secretary of the Biosafety Agency. Both of them spoke on this issue yesterday. And the conclusion by the Minister of Agriculture is that even internationally, more so less in Nigeria, there is no conclusive impact assessment that will tell us that product of GMOs, whether at the farm end or at the consumption end, are safe, potent. And until that studies are done conclusively, we have to carry. That is what the minister has said. And I think it is in the spirit of this body, which means we need to look properly, we need to investigate, and we have to also educate our people. Not just to see a beautiful apple. Sir, I have an apple I wanted to see. I'm waiting to have. It looks so beautiful. And when you test it, you see it is sweet and sour at the same time. So it means they are just playing with the taste, with the system, and they are just for economic purposes. So we need to look at it very, very carefully. Again, finally, the issue, there are ethical issues. By technology, and here's the issue of modifying the genes of either human beings or plants, that is living organisms, has ethical issues. It has legal implications. Just like the issue of surrogate mother and test tube babies and so on. Who is the actual mother? For example, in India, it's also now there is an issue of transferring. You know, if somebody has an accident and he is brain dead and the other one has good body, they take the head and put on the other body. That's what they do also. Who wants it? Is it the heart that controls the human, or is it the head that controls? Who is the person? It's exactly what is happening. So in terms of health, in terms of economy, in terms of profit, that is what we are being focused on. So this motion must be sustained. This motion must be supported, and the two committees, must work fast so that we can get the minister and the ministry and everybody, stakeholders, to make sure that the Nigerian population is protected not only from cancer, but from even modified people. Look at this.